Item number SCP-489. Object class Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-489 is held in a containment unit at Site 113. To prevent personnel accidentally bringing insect life into SCP-489's cell, a shower room has been established outside of the containment cell. Personnel will change into the clothes provided to them after cleaning. Testing with SCP-489 is limited to indoor spaces. Due to the potential of containment breach and site damage, at no point may insectile-based anomalies, including instances of SCP-831, be stored at Site 113. Description: SCP-489 is a roughly dome-shaped conglomerate mass, consisting entirely of objects used to kill or repel insects, e.g., aerosol pesticide cans, bug zappers, fly swatters, footwear, and lighters. Each item is capable of independent autonomous movement, though they usually move along the ground as a whole when in motion. As of June 17, 2013, SCP-489 measures roughly 5 meters in height and 8 meters in diameter at the base. There is a badly damaged transit van in the center of the mass, which contains a human skeleton sitting in the driver's seat. The skeleton's ribcage has been crushed. A faded, scratched logo can be seen on the right side of the van, which reads, "Extreme Extermination, Sick, Services. We'll bash any bug, big or small. 1555 Bug Bash." When an insect of any species comes within 5 meters of SCP-489, SCP-489 will surge towards the animal and attempt to kill it. Of note is that SCP-489 is heedless of other non-insect organisms, should an insect be on or nearby them when attacking, usually resulting in severe injury or death should said organisms fail to move in time. However, due to the number of objects moving at once, SCP-489 often fails to reach the target at all, instead having individual parts impede one another's movement. If SCP-489 fails to kill the insects, individual items on SCP-489 become hostile to one another and begin hitting objects adjacent to them. When not in the presence of an insect, SCP-489 is relatively docile, making study of it easier. Should SCP-489 successfully terminate an insect, objects capable of handling it safely, e.g. tweezers, shovels, etc., will retrieve and pass the insect along the edge of SCP-489 towards the storage space of SCP-489. During this time, it becomes possible to see the transit van without imaging due to items moving out of the way to open the doors. The storage space of the van in SCP-489 possesses extra-dimensional properties, containing dozens of rows of glass jars, stored on wooden shelves. Every jar is full of various dead insects. If presented with new objects that would be considered bug killers, SCP-489 will readily attempt to incorporate them into itself. However, this habit makes its goal of exterminating insects even more difficult with the newly acquired mass. Newly added items immediately show signs of sentience. When new items are introduced to SCP-489, other items will enter the van's storage space and bring numerous jars containing disproportionately large specimens to the front of the storage space. These samples appear to serve as trophies for SCP-489. Each jar is labeled with a date and how the insect was obtained. Newly added items will gather around these jars in apparent admiration. Here is a list of several specimens SCP-489 has presented. Description: 3 beetle-like creatures, each measuring 1.5 meters in length. The abdomens are covered in large, thorn-like protrusions. The Savage Spine-Shooting Beetles, obtained July 7th, 1989. The beasts were terrorizing the village of Lathos in Thoazola, brought down with the help of Julie and her garden gang. Description: a thin, knobby, elongated creature resembling a stick insect, with an additional 6 pairs of legs. Each leg measures roughly 2.5 meters. Body length is roughly 5 meters. The Walking Lance. Obtained December 20th, 1984. Found roaming the jagged rocky mountains of Jarinth. Its bladed legs felled Karen and Matthew before a well-aimed shot from Maxwell skewered its head. Description: a horseshoe crab-like creature with prominent mandibles, paddle-like legs, and several sack-like growths lining its back and underbelly. Length, roughly 2 meters. The Aquatic Venomous Floater Bug. Obtained March 26, 1987. A new challenge. One that took place beneath the waters of the Burmese swamplands. We have the scars to show for it, but the beast fell after the puncturing of its venom sacs. Description: a humanoid entity 1.8 meters in height, with eyes and proboscis resembling a housefly, Musca domestica. The Bugman. Obtained May 5th, 1991. Found within the frozen hills of Russia. Well worth the battle and losses. Theo and the Torch's sacrifice will be honored by all bug killers for eternity. Description: an arthropod with 4 thick short legs, all spreading from its abdomen in a circle. Creature has large elongated pincers, and a head featuring a prominent proboscis and compound eyes. Height, roughly 4 meters. The Bug That Killed Master. Obtained November 18th, 2000. Master fought hard, but he had finally met a bug he couldn't kill. We fought for him and made it suffer, but we couldn't save our leader. Description: a wooden case with several pinned, non-anomalous butterflies, beetles, and dried earthworms. Our first kills after Master's death. Obtained from February to April of 2001. We will carry on Master's work. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-488, Meteor Attractor, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.